Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. My name's Emily and happy Princess Week. This week is actually Princess Week, so yeah, hope you're having a princessy time today. I have a little review of something that arrived in the mail, which I'm super excited about. As you can probably tell by the title, it is my new Ariel Pandora bead charm, and I'm really excited about it. I'm going to give you a little bit of backstory, how I purchased it, the price, and all those details in this video. So if you'd like to hear about that, then please keep on watching. I would like to say that I have had a really good experience so far with my other DHgate Pandora purchase. I bought this unreleased Ariel tiara ring from DHgate recently, and I've worn it for a couple of days now and it has not tarnished. I do believe it is sterling silver and it's really good quality and condition, and yeah, it's my new like everyday kind of ring into my everyday ring stack. I'm obsessed with it and I have a whole video up on my channel if you'd like to see that. I also have a video up on my channel of this makeup look that I'm wearing right now, which is inspired by a Charlotte Tilbury look, if you'd like to check that out. It's also already live. But yeah, I'm gonna get straight into the charm. So I've already opened the packaging, but it came in one of these little yellow like postage envelopes that is lined with a bubble wrap, and you know, it's just one of these envelopes, and inside it came in a little Ziploc bag. It has this little barcode on the front of the Ziploc bag, and the charm was just loose in there. I plan on wearing this charm probably on my bangle. I have a Pandora bangle that I've actually never put any beads on because I just liked the way it looked bare, but when I saw this charm online, I just knew I wanted to get it. So usually, if you know me, I usually just purchase things directly from Pandora because I have like it's in my budget to purchase from Pandora. But the reason that I usually purchase things off DHgate is because they're out of my budget, but I'd like to get like a similar item, like get the look for less kind of vibes. So I decided to get this off DHgate, even though it is a Pandora item, because this is really hard to find. Same with this obviously unreleased ring. You know, this is very hard to find because it's not released in Australia or anywhere to my knowledge. This was really difficult to find. I couldn't find this bead anywhere in Australian stores. I do have one other Little Mermaid Disney Pandora kind of item, which is this one, and it's also a silhouette. There are other Little Mermaid Disney Pandora beads, but none of them were ones that I particularly wanted. I'm very particular with the things that I get, and I really wanted like a silhouette of Ariel. This one that I'm wearing on my necklace is a really nice one because I like the way the pendant hangs and it's really nice. Even though it's a bead, I like wearing this one as a necklace, whereas I felt like this one was a bead. Sorry, Uber Eats has arrived and my dog is not vibing. So yeah, Pandora Disney does have a couple of Ariel beads, but I don't really like any of the ones that are out at the moment, except for the newest one. I kind of prefer a more simple style, like with the silhouette. The one that has a three-dimensional mermaid sitting on a pearl isn't really my style at the moment, and so I really like the simplicity and the elegance of this bead. I like how she's on a little silhouetted backdrop, and I love that it's got that transparent clear gem in the back. My sister has a very similar bead that is from the Belle, like the Beauty and the Beast collection, that's kind of got the same kind of bead as the backdrop, that's like supposed to be rose themed, and I really like how this is similar to her one except Ariel themed. So I'm going to show you close-ups later on, but I'll show you first me popping on this bangle. This bangle is another Pandora bangle that I was gifted from a friend ages and ages ago. It's a really pretty one. I believe it was like a Christmas limited edition one or something, because it has the snowflake clasp, and then on the front it says unique as you are. It kind of gives me Frozen vibes, which is cute. Frozen's not my favorite Disney movie, obviously Ariel is, but I do really like Frozen, especially Frozen 2. Anyway, that's what it looks like on the bracelet. So it does fit a normal Pandora kind of bracelet, and on the actual charm it does say S925, which means like sterling 925. It does have really nice details all the way around, and it does look really cute on the charm bracelet. Let me see if I can slip it over. Yeah, I'm really into it. So yeah, that's what the bead looks like. I'll show you the close-ups of it now, but I'm totally stoked with it and it feels a decent quality. I do believe it is sterling silver. I have no way of like testing that other than just like wearing and seeing if it tarnishes over time, but I feel like this won't, because the other one that I purchased also from DHgate didn't. Also, I'll link the seller that I purchased it from in the description box down below if you would like to shop from the same link as I did. Here is a screenshot of my receipt and how much I paid for it. This is the seller's listing, and as you can see, that is what the charm looks like in real life when it arrived. So here are some different angles of like pictures from the listing and stuff, and it looks really good on a necklace too. Here is some of the description from the listing. I'm really into charms that look like
silhouettes, as I mentioned, because ones with faces on them, like this one and also this one, the faces are just so small, it's hard to get the detail looking nice. However, I am into this new bead, which they just came out with, because the face looks really good. I placed my order with the seller on the 26th of July, and it arrived at my house on the 23rd of August. So it took just under a month to arrive, which was reasonable to me. Also, I tried to find other pictures of this charm from Pandora online, but I couldn't find any. So maybe Pandora never came out with this charm. I don't know. I don't really care because I think it's stunning. I initially found out and discovered this charm from seeing it in really cute Instagram posts from other aerial lovers like this one.
I know that there are a lot of fake or dupe Pandora beads out there, but I actually haven't purchased any until I purchased this bead. So this is like the first one I've tried. Otherwise, I'm like usually just someone who gets them from Pandora because that's within my budget. This one is my authentic Pandora bead, and I'll be comparing it to the one from DHgate today. This one is so pretty. It's got a silhouette of Ariel dangling in front of a kind of like backing that's got some like tail details, like scaly details, and I love how on the side there it's like a shell, a starfish, and a little gem. It's so cute. And then on the actual bead, it has Pandora written on it, and then it says S925ALE. On the back, it says part of your world. I'll just zoom in to the side of the bead so you can see the details engraved into the side there. Oops, sorry. It just says it like that, Pandora S925ALE. And so this is the dupe bead that I purchased, and I'll show you the front first. So it just has this Little Mermaid silhouette, which I love because these two silhouettes are my two favorite silhouettes of Ariel from the whole movie. When she's swimming up to the surface of the water with like this silhouette in this pose, I think it's a stunning moment. And I love this one with the sunset behind her. I think these are like the two most iconic poses. So I was really stoked to be able to get both of these. So I love this pose. She's sitting on a little rock, which has some little engraved detail in it. And then all around the bead, there are these little bumps, like little bubbles. And then in the center of the bead on both sides, there is a clear, like, I don't want to say green because it's like a blue-toned green gem in the center of it. It's just like a clear one. I think it might be glass or something. I don't know. I don't really mind. And then all around the edge of the bead, there is this little, I don't know what to call this, like teardrop shaped pattern all around it, which is really pretty and a nice detail. So yeah, one side is plain, it has no engraving on it, and then the other side has the engraving, and it says, I'm not sure what that first one is, but it says S925 after that. It does not have ALE written on it, and it does not have the Pandora engraving on it, which is not an issue to me, but like, you know, I'm sure it's not for some people. I don't really mind because I don't really care about the branding on it. I just like the design of the charm. I think it objectively is like a really pretty bead, but you know, normal Pandora beads do have Pandora written on them, so I just thought I'd point that out. I'm really into it. I think it looks very like similar. It's a very nice bead by itself aesthetically, but it does look very similar to a Pandora bead. It fits obviously the right size for a bracelet or a bangle from Pandora, so it looks cute on this bracelet I have, I mean bangle that I have, but I think it'd look cute on a random chain. This bead that I have here, I just have strung on like a random chain, and I like wearing that one as a necklace instead, and I think it looks really cute. By the way, this bangle is one from my friend, so that's a little close-up of that one. I've shown you guys this one before. I've had it for ages, and it's one that I wear all the time. I really love this, but yeah. Also, one more thing I wanted to mention is, I'm not sure if you'll be able to tell. Yeah, you can. There is a little bit of gap between the actual silhouette and the bead. It isn't pressed totally flat to the bead. I don't believe it's got enough of a gap to catch on anything, but it is just something to be mindful that, you know, the tail does stick off a little bit, but that's normal. But yeah, there is a gap between the head of the silhouette and the bead, if that makes sense. By the way, the bead is like faceted. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that. It has all these little facets on it. It's really pretty. And yeah, that is all I have to say today about my new charm, which I'm so excited about. I love it so much. I don't really have like a huge wish list of charms. There aren't a lot of charms that I feel like I want, just because it's not really my style anymore to have a lot of charms. I prefer like having one simple dangling one, or just like one here and there on a plain bracelet. So I don't see myself in the future purchasing a lot more charms, but it was cute to get like this one, because this one was a little bit more difficult to find. I couldn't find this in any of the stores in Australia around me. If Disney did come out with more like aerial charms with Pandora in the future, I would definitely be interested, because you know, obviously they're really cute and stuff, and I'm always down to get more aerial things, but only if there's something that I think is really beautiful and is definitely my style. So yeah, that's all I have to say today. If you liked this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Subscribe if you'd like to see more content from from me. I'd love to hear your thoughts, so don't be shy, send me a message, anything like that. You can also hit the join button down below to become a paid member of my channel to see more exclusive content from me, and I'll catch you next time. Bye!